All right, listen up. Private Martin, you're on the obstacle course and doing weapons training today. Before starting the obstacle course, read each of these important signs and do what they tell you. Good. Now check your objectives. You'll notice that your current objective is highlighted. In addition, the location of your current objective is marked by the star on your compass. As you approach your current objective, the star will move toward the center of your compass. Approach your current objective. That's it. Close enough. You will notice that objective is checked off and you now have a new one.
Martin, all right, good Martin, to see you.
Open the gate and run
the
obstacle
course. Butt here too, huh?
Go, go, go!
Hey,
move it, ladies!
Good luck.
This is not your Aunt Fanny's dance! Jump over him! Come on, Elder, get the lead out! Not bad. Now hit the dirt and crawl forward under the barbed wire. Sergeant, fire up those machine guns! Stay low! Stay down! Climb these ladders, privates! Let's go, let's go, let's go! Private Martin, proceed through that door. Sergeant Moody's gonna
Eyes
take you
up,
through
Private.
Weapons training.
I'm up here,
the rest of you
in
ladies,
the observation
right
tower. Grab one of those M1A1 carbines from the table. To get more ammo, grab it from any loose weapon of the same type you are carrying. Approach the fence and fire 6 rounds at your target. Your accuracy will be defined by the tightness of your crosshairs. Fire 6 more rounds at your target, in different stances and while moving. You will be more accurate while not moving, and crouching or prone positions. These skills could mean your life. All right, Private, move on to the next area. Grab up a Springfield rifle from the table, switching it for your carbine. Turn to the left. Move to the fence and fire 2 rounds at your target. Now fire 2 rounds at your target while aiming down your sight. All right, I hope it's clear to you that you will be more accurate while aiming down the sight. All right, Private, move on to the next area. Exchange your Springfield for one of the Thompson submachine guns on the table. Unless you've got 3 hands, you can only carry 2 weapons, besides your sidearm and grenades. Fire 10 rounds at your target, first from the hip, then aiming down the gun sight. Compare your accuracy. Get used to firing both ways. Notice a slight zoom effect when you raise and aim down the sight of a weapon with a scope. Take a few steps while aiming down your sight. You're gonna move slower this way. In close quarters combat, you can hit your enemy with the butt end of your weapon. This is called a melee attack. Try it with your Thompson. Don't screw around, kid. This is for real. Now switch weapons, Private. Unless you're as dumb as you are ugly, it may dawn on you that each weapon is good for different situations. Make the wrong choice and you could buy the farm. Fire 3 more rounds at your target. Outstanding, Private. Proceed to the next area. Pick up the frag grenades from the table. Pick them up. Throw a grenade into each of the openings before you. Rock and fire. Move behind the concrete post and lean out to the left, then the right. This will help protect you from the enemy.
What?
move on to the next area. Remember, Private, if you get hurt, grab one of those health kits and use it. Don't be a hero. They will save your life. Our last station will be explosives. Pick them up, partner. That's a lot of firepower there. Treat it with respect. That stuff doesn't care what it blows up. Place your explosives on the cinder block wall. Note that a stopwatch has appeared. This will tell you how much time you have to get your butt out of there unless you want it. Good job, Private. Well done. Keep your weapons with you.
Baker Company, listen up. This is the big one. Operation Overlord, the air and seaborne invasion of Normandy. On H hour D-Day, seaborne infantry will attack 5 beaches codenamed Utah, Omaha, Gold, Juno, and Sword here on the coast of Normandy. Utah and Omaha beaches will be attacked by 3 of our infantry divisions. At the same time, 2 British and 1 Canadian division will hit Gold, Juno, and Sword beaches. The airborne will be landing 6 hours before H hour, before the air and naval bombardments. The British 6th Airborne Division will be landing here. At the same time, the 101st and the 82nd Airborne will be landing in these areas. The Dues River Estuary here divides Utah and Omaha Beach. The mission of the 101st is to capture the Dues River crossings linking Utah and Omaha Beach and to protect the flanks of Utah Beach. This road here is the main highway that connects the entire Cotentin Peninsula. The Germans have troop concentrations in this region. When those troops are mobilized into a counterattack on the beaches, they'll have to move along this road. The 101st is going to make sure that doesn't happen. Baker Company, that's us, has been assigned this causeway here. The Pathfinders, like Private Martin, will be dropped ahead of the main force and will plant beacons on the ground to mark the landing zones. However, there is no telling what will happen once we're on the ground. So I want all of you to learn the objectives of every unit in both the 101st and 82nd. I also want you to study these maps and photographs until you've memorized them. We will be landing behind the Atlantic Wall, between several German garrisons. We can't expect to be relieved until at least several hours after H hour. This is what we've been training for. Good luck.
Wir werden es als Erste wissen. Sie kommen mitten durch so Mary Gries.
Falsch. Der Lama Roosevelt und Vetter Churchill würden hier niemals angreifen.
Ist sie weit weg von Deutschland? Hat sie Angst?
Na, weil sie diesen Sektor schon seit Wochen bombardieren.
Na und?
Hier!
Bombardieren doch alles. Was mich schon besonders interessiert.
Secure the perimeter! You guys, over here! By the wall! Defensive positions, get down!
guys, get set to move. On my command. Let's go, let's go!
Suppressing fire on the 42! Fire! Area on the right! Faster! Keep moving forward! back! Fire in the hole!
Dirigez mi casa!
Thank you, Steve!
All right, fellas. Take five, but listen up. We'll hold this place till reinforced. This is just one tiny village in a warring country full of them, so our work has just begun. For those of you who've seen your first action, welcome to the big time. For those of you who've seen it before, trust me, you ain't seen nothing yet. We'll redeploy those German machine guns, setting up a defensive perimeter. Keep your guard up and your buddies in mind. Good work. Mortars are taking a break. Johnson, go have a look.
Right, Captain.
Panzer, come! Take it out! We'll hold off their infantry!
Martin, over here! Get in the car! Okay, Captain. Assuming we get back to battalion in this rolling junkyard, what do I tell him?
Hand this directly to Major Shepard. Tell him Baker Company has secured the town, but won't be able to hold it long if we don't get relief soon. Got that, Sergeant?
Oh, yes, sir, you bet. We ride through enemy lines in a French tin can. Want to paint a bullseye on it, sir?
Yeah, pretty sure that won't be necessary, Sarge. So unless you've got a better idea or a radio that works, carry on. Good luck.
Oh, man, this is nuts. I can't believe we're doing this.
Believe it. Unless you sprout wings and want to fly. It's only 6 miles, Private. Just shut up and do your job. Get your ass out! Let's go, Martin! Move it! Move!
I can't believe I agreed to do this!
You did, remember? Elder, ever steal a car?
Only when I need one, Sarge.
Martin, cover! Damn it, Elder, hurry up!
Working, Sarge, I'm working on it!
Quit working, then get done! God, this is on you!
Got it.
In the car. Martin, cover us. Step on it. Get us out of here.
I gotta go report in to Major Shepard and get our orders. Take five, but stay put.
Okie doke, Sarge. What the hell else am I gonna do?
Third squad, get your 30 cal to cover our flank. Second squad, follow in reserve. I got point. Elder and Martin on my tail. Everybody set? Let's go!
This cannon's about to go boom! explosives and try to shut your artillery down.
Second platoon, move in and secure these buildings. Now, let's go! Heads up, Jerry's outside. Grab that MG-42 and use it.
Ah!
First platoon, listen up. Sergeant Moody owes me $50 because it looks like Operation Overlord was a success. Our British and Canadian friends took most of their objectives. And except for Omaha, all the beach landings went pretty smoothly. The airborne was misdropped everywhere, but the men formed mixed units and accomplished most of the airborne D-Day objectives. I am extremely proud of all of you. As you know, Sergeant Moody and Privates Elder and Martin broke through German lines to get word to battalion headquarters. If it wasn't for their success, HQ probably would not have sent the reinforcements that helped us hold St. Mary-Église. At headquarters, Moody, Elder, and Martin were assigned to silence a German battery at Braycourt Manor and faced an entire platoon of Germans with only a handful of men. Well, it seems that someone at command noticed your actions. Our unit has been detached from the rest of the 101st so that it can be used for some special missions behind enemy lines. I suggest that you brush up on your German, gentlemen, and enjoy your R&R while you can.
There's an MG-42 on the left, with a guardhouse on the right. They didn't spot me.
Let's hope. Captain Price and Major Ingram?
Probably in the big house up the road.
Martin, you take point, knock out that 42. Harding and Brooks, go get the truck. Meet us at the front of the chateau. Everyone else, follow Martin. Move!
Let's do it all over.
get in there, grab any docs, knock out their communications, then meet back up with us. Sergeant Moody and I will find Price and Ingram.
Schicken Sie uns einen MG-42.
Schicken Sie uns einen MG-42.
Der Feind! Alter Feind!
Thank you.
Good job. All right, guys, we're moving on. Don't stop now. Bryce and Ingram are behind these doors. Stand back. We're gonna blow them.
Well, goodness me, Americans.
Get down!
Made quite a racket, didn't you? That's quite all right. I can still walk.
Captain Price, Captain Foley. Where's Major Ingram?
They moved him to a camp. Not to worry, I overheard where.
Truck's up front, sir.
Excellent. Help Captain Price out the window. He's been hurt. Let's pile in. We're getting out.
Captain, what about Major Ingram?
We'll be back for him. Get in. Okay, Martin. We're about ready to ram the gate, with less than 10 minutes from your first shot to pull this off. Take any longer, they'll be sending someone to rescue us. You take out the front guards, concentrating on the machine gun nests. Once the gate is down, get in there and find the Major. Then rendezvous back at the truck.
base of fire. This
come to collect me, have you? Lead on, lads. No time for handshakes and hellos.
Gentlemen, thus far you've been training hard at Exeter for a special purpose. This special purpose, obviously, has something to do with the capturing of bridges. What I'm about to explain is top secret material. If any of you blokes mention the word bridge outside of this room and I hear of it, and I will, it'll be RTU'd on the spot. The invasion of Europe will take place across 5 main beaches along the Normandy coast of France. Elements of the British Second Army will strike at Gold and Sword beaches, along with the 3rd Canadian Infantry Division at Juneau. To the west, the Yanks will take Utah and Omaha Beach. Now, the entire eastern flank of the invasion will be exposed to a German counterattack from the Calais region. Should the Germans break through, they could very well have tanks rolling through Sword Beach and all the way down to Utah, wiping out the entire beachhead. Our task, along with the rest of the 6th Airborne Division, is to secure that flank at all costs by capturing and holding key bridges along the axis of approach. D Company's objective is this bridge over the Caen Canal. Under cover of darkness, the gliders will put us down in the field next to the bridge. From there, we rush the pillbox and prevent the Germans from blowing the bridge. At least one Bren gun will provide a base of fire while we flank it from both sides. Once we've captured the bridge, we hold it until relieved, which could take several hours. During that time, we may find ourselves using the Germans' own weapons against them. So I suggest you familiarize yourselves with the captured ones we have on base. Good luck, and Godspeed. Dismissed!
Thank you.
God's sake, Jack. It's the biggest forest in Normandy. Pay attention.
I am. It's not there.
Well, perhaps they moved. By my calculations, we're on course. We're rocked back north 2 degrees. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and bingo.
2 degrees starboard onto course.
All right, everyone, brace for landing. Bloody odd landing, eh?
Is everyone all right? Mills!
Yeah, I'm fine. Just great.
Button up! Let's go! Let's go!
Move! Move! Move. Come on!
Sergeant Evans, glad you're still with us. We're in luck. The Germans haven't responded to our stellar landing. Find a good spot to suppress their bunker. We'll advance behind your base of fire.
Jürgen, hast du doch eben auch was gehört?
Es ist nichts. Wie immer. Bestimmt nur ein Stück von einem britischen Bomber.
Get it working. Follow me.
Thank you.
clear!
Captain, we salvaged the area. Apart from some medical supplies, all we found were a couple of rifles and several Panzerfausts, which are woefully inaccurate.
Thank God we still have that flak gun. We can use it to hold the bridge until our relief shows up.
Fall back to the bridge on my command!
Thank you.
way! Southwest! Across the town! That's the last of them. Excellent work, lads. Bloody well done.
All right, settle down. We got new orders straight from SOE, as well as two new transfers from the 6th Airborne to help us carry them out. They were highly recommended for this operation as a result of their actions on D-Day. Captain Price, Sergeant Evans, welcome to 3 Troop. Now, let's get down to business. These are the locations of the major hydroelectric dams in the Ruhr industrial region of Germany. Their main purpose is to provide electrical power to the factories and cities throughout the area. Last year, a clever fellow by the name of Dr. Barnes Wallace created an odd sort of bomb that was specially designed to breach these dams.
Using these bombs, the dam busters from 617 Squadron successfully breached the Mona and Ida dams, causing extensive flooding and damage to the industrial heart of Germany. The bad news is the bastards have already repaired the damage done, and Bomber Command wants to have another crack at these targets. This is the Ida Dam. We're to make a night drop on this one. From the DZ, it's a day's tab through unpopulated areas around the dam's reservoir. Dropping in any closer is impossible, as the enemy flak is simply too concentrated around the dam itself. Our mission is to locate as many of these anti-air guns as possible, wipe them out so that the bombers can make their runs. This building at the foot of the dam houses the electrical generators. Our orders are to blow this structure in the event that the bombers fail to breach the dam. We set the explosives on a short timer, then get the hell out of there by truck to a nearby airfield and appropriate suitable air transport from the enemy. You all know what to do. Check and test your magazines, zero your sights, and review the maps and photographs carefully. We'll receive signals and embarkation details within the next 2 hours. Good luck.
Angriffe gegen Sektor 6 ergeben BP-Entdeckung. ab, bevor sie das Kraftwerk. Sektor 6 ergeben Befehl. Aufnahmen dann mit abgeschnitten. Leutnant Graf, stellen Sie mit Ihrem Trupp die Verbindung wieder her.
Booby traps to blow when
the bloody hell's he doing? My gods, we've made it. I don't bloody believe it. We're coming up on that airfield where the rest of the team has assembled. They radioed that they're finding us an escape plane.
Okay, we're clear to approach. Evans, you and I will need to get below decks and find the armory before we can cripple the engines. Stick with me, and unless your Germans improve, let me handle the talking.
Waters, you stay here. Be ready to leave at a moment's notice.
Bitte um Erlaubnis, um an Bord kommen zu dürfen.
Erlaubnis erteilt.
Dürfte ich wohl Ihre Papiere sehen? Wo ist Fregattenkapitän Schmidt?
Er musste zu einem dringenden Treffen mit Admiral Dönitz.
Alles in Ordnung. Willkommen an Bord.
We should be able to get below through that hangar.
Dürfte ich wohl Ihre Papiere mal sehen? Ich muss das überprüfen. Einen Moment bitte. Ich habe einen Offizier hier. Er sagt, er habe Papiere.
Hallo? Hallo?
Grab a weapon and explosives, quick! The ship's boilers line these passageways. Place your charges as we go. This place will be crawling with crowds.
the captain. Damn, that was a very fine man. Let's get the hell out of here.
Comrades of the Soviet Union, almost 1 year has passed since the German invaders set foot upon the soil of our motherland. They have advanced deep into the Soviet Union, capturing city after city, raping, murdering, and robbing the Soviet people. Although our situation grows desperate, we have one last hope of defense. The city that bears our great leader's name, Stalingrad. Comrades, many of your countrymen are already there, defying the Germans at every step. Soon, you will stand alongside them, and you will not fail to defeat our fascist enemies. No one shall take even one step backwards. Commissars will execute cowards on sight, giving faithful soldiers a chance to do their duty. The motherland is counting on you to achieve victory at Stalingrad.
Comrades, this day will be the proudest day you have ever lived. You will fight the fascist Nazi invaders with all your strength. For each and every fallen Soviet soldier, you will make them pay with 10 of theirs. There will be no mercy for defeatists, cowards, or traitors. Anyone caught deserting his post will be shot. Remember great Comrade Stalin's order. Not one step backwards. You will be well equipped for the battles that lie ahead. You will have food, water, weapons, and plenty of ammunition. What do you suppose the Germans have? Nothing! Their supply lines are stretched thin. Their dash to the Volga has left them without the means to bring us a proper fight. With our superior strength in numbers and our boundless courage, victory is ours! We shall stop the fascist invaders! There! Stalingrad!
see that truck over there? Wait for them to reload. Then run for it and don't stop. My signal. Ready. Okay, go, go, go.
Thank you.
bring in reinforcements!
Taken Red Square. You'll report to him from here on out.
Take cover!
Take cover!
Schutz finden! Over here!
of the Soviet Union. There is no need for this senseless bloodshed between our nations. The German people are not your enemy. If you surrender, you will be treated well. You will be given plenty of good hot food and warm clothing.
In the ditch and keep your head down. They've got snipers out there. Private Kovayenko, as the fastest man here, you will be debayed.
Me? Oh, no, thank you, comrade.
That is an order! Alexei will cover you with the sniper rifle from here. Now go, before I shoot you myself!
Cover!
Comrade Alexei, we've got those anti-tank rifles on the second and third floor. You take out the tanks. We'll stop the troops. Here they come! Ready on the anti-tank rifles!
Anti-tank rifles ready!
Machine gun!
Hold this position!
Ah!
keine Ladehemmungen.
Feindliche Granate!
Granate!
Our generals are racing to Berlin.
Da, for the women in the race.
The general who gets to Berlin last will be sent for re-education.
We'll be re-educated with them if the NKVD.
Oh.
still alive? Well,
good. That's good.
We must get out of here quickly before the artillery starts.
Thank you.
up, comrades!
Since June of 1944, the Allies have made enormous advances through Europe, sweeping through much of France, Belgium, and Holland, almost to the banks of the Rhine. Much of their success must be credited to the Russians, who at Stalingrad, during the winter of 1943, destroyed many of the Germans' best panzer divisions. On the Eastern Front, the Russians have continued to push the Germans back through Russia and much of Poland, and will soon be on the banks of the Oder River and the border of Germany. The situation for the Germans has grown desperate. Allied bombers have reduced many major German cities to rubble. The German Air Force, the Luftwaffe, is a mere shadow of the power it once was, and can do little to stop the bombers, much less fight the Allied armies. The Kriegsmarine, the German Navy, is mostly sunk, its U-boats destroyed, and its sailors pressed into the army. However, the enemy refuses to surrender. Unable to stop the Allied advance, Hitler has turned to vengeance weapons, the V-1 and now the V-2 rockets. These rockets, although some of the most advanced weapons of the war, are too inaccurate to hit military targets. Instead, they are being used to terrorize London.
Gentlemen, we fought a whole bunch of these, so I know you know what to do, but indulge me. Move quickly, cover your buddies, don't bunch up, and for heaven's sake, don't stop till we reach those bunkers.
Not there! Watch out for those mines!
Guys,
Squad, move up!
Great job on those tanks. Private Martin, you've done yourself proud. I can hardly believe you've done it.
All right, Evans. We'll head east, destroying any targets of opportunity. Then we'll meet up with the rest of the squad as planned. You take point, I'll provide support with the Brenda.
Evans, we need to blow up that flat gun.
Get it!
Evans, we need to blow up that flat gun. Go! Good show, Evans. Bloody decent work. You may have just... Smashing good use of mines. No time to chat. We'll be moving north to find those V2s now. All right then, move it. Move along.
Move in!
quickly.
Thank you. Mother, a few days ago, we waved the flag of the motherland over the top of the Reichstag in Berlin. The war, at last, seems to be coming to an end. There is very little fighting left in the enemy. Soon I will be returning to our home. There are German prisoners of war everywhere. Today, I crossed the Elbe River in Germany and shook hands with an American soldier. Although I could not understand anything he said, I felt this man was my brother. And I think he felt the same.